It's spring break! Yeah, spring break, guys! Man! Crank that up! Oh my god! Spring break! Let's hit the beaches! Yo, why didn't them girls have their shirts off yet?
Hey everybody, what's going on? This is Will here, and it's spring break. I am so excited, and also the fact that, I have a week off. I love spring break, man. Mostly because I can just keep going, SPRING BREAK! While my cat jumps up on my lap while I'm trying to record. There we go. And then he, like, runs away ever so jauntily when I put him down. Good lord. Alright, so in the last episode of Pokemon Heart Gold, we did a whole bunch of stuff. Good lord. We beat down Team Rocket. We had a rematch with Dinkles. Geez, what else did we do? We took on the Azalea Gym, and we beat Bugsy and his bug team. That I thought were going to be a bit more of a challenge than I thought. I guess I was underestimating Agent Spooner's abilities, but anyway. Yeah, we got all that done. Just in the last episode, good lord, in just a little under 24 minutes, I guess it was. But now we have to do this, man. We have to do this far-fetched puzzle, which again got switched up quite a bit from the previous game. Basically, all you have to do is interact with Farfetch'd from behind, and that's how you do it. Yeah. Though I believe we have to do it again because there's two of them this time. There we go. So yeah, instead of me getting to memorize the puzzle like in the original, if I was playing the original, I'd be done with this like by now probably. But anyway, we have to do this slightly switched up puzzle, which again is nice. I mean, I'm glad that they acknowledge that people are like going to know that, you know, that the game is switched up a little bit. Alright. So what happens if we click on him from the front? He runs away. Okay. Cool. So now he's standing in that direction. So I think what we have to do with the second one kind of, it's more reminiscent of the original puzzle where you kind of have to interact with him. To get him to run around till you get him in a spot that you can exploit the mechanics. So I'll show you guys what I mean here. As we keep talking to this Farfetch'd here, he's just going to keep, you know, going around in the corners and stuff. But you see, what we want to do is we want to get him... Let's see here. See what we can do. See what happens if we do that. There we go. Okay, so that's where we want him. Because now, we can just go over here. We can alert him with that. And then we just have to walk ever so slightly around the corner. And get into a wild fight with a Caterpie, probably. Oh, they're switching it up. Oh, it's a Metapod this time. I'm sorry, I shouldn't be such an arsehole about it. I'll make it up to you, Metapod. I'll actually KO you this time. I'll give you the pleasure of battling me. Look at that. It's not every day somebody gets to fight a Spearow like this, so, you know, take that to heart. Take that with you tonight when you go to sleep. And we're gonna talk to the Farfetch'd, man. And that should be it. You got both of them. Thank you so much. My boss's Pokemon won't obey me because I don't have a badge. Well, dude, they're too Farfetch'd. You should be able to beat Bugsy with them. Phew, you saved me. And then his boss comes out. He's like, oh, thank you so much for helping my Farfetch'd because my incompetent assistant apprentice can't do anything. And then he gives you cut. Look at that. Oh, also, this is something that Jared suggested, which I think is friggin' hilarious, and I'm totally going to follow through on. He wants me to teach Flash to Michelle Ruff, so I'm gonna friggin' do that right now before I forget. I don't know how long I'll hold on to it, but man, I've got to do this for gag's sake. Like, honestly. Like, you can't get much better than Michelle Ruff flashing you, really. I mean, is there really much more to life than that? We'll get rid of Poison Powder. You know, that'll probably bite me in the ass later, but that's alright. That's all good. It's fine. Not so good. It's fine. I don't see anything that could go wrong. Oh, good. And the only person I can use cut is Michelle Ruff. You know, let's play the rest of the episode at night. You know, it's been a while since we played it at night. Like, why not, right? Go. This is actually part of an event that was downloadable in the original game, and they sort of brought it back in the remake. I think they just brought it back for a different event. It used to be a a mobile transfer event in Japan that could give you the GS ball. And when you had the GS ball and went to that shrine here in Ilex Forest, you would get access to a Celebi. It's very cool. I forgot what level the Celebi was at, though. Friggin' Paris, man. Now you decide to show up. I see how it is. I'll kill this Paris just out of spite. And so that Michelle Ruff can level up again. That too. There we go. Look at you go, Michelle. Oh, that's great. I'll post a link in the description. There's this friggin' video I found of Michelle Ruff's interview from Behind the Voice Actor, which is it's like a documentary about voice acting, the voice acting industry and stuff. I love listening to it. I just love hearing her voice. It's beautiful. It's amazing. She just sounds like so sassy and serious. Just like, that's just her demeanor. Like, her general demeanor is just sassy but serious, and I love it. It's fantastic. Alright. See, I don't want to throw Martha Stewart in front, even though she needs to get raised, because if I do that, then I'll, like, have a hard time running away from everything. I won't bother going that way either. Do I have, like, a repel or something? That might help a bit. I do, too. Look at that. Look at that. Good lord, man. There's also a move I want to learn in here. See that fat guy down there? He teaches you a cool move. Alright. You gotta circle all the way around here, though. Good lord. It's a pain, but... See, look. Oh my god, dude! He's just... Man, look how fat he is! He's making the whole world shake. What am I doing? I'm shaking trees using headbutt. It's fun. Here, you try it with your Pokemon, too. Alright. This is a move that I always teach, There we go. I'll always kind of teach it to the Pokemon that can learn it. But usually has, like, Tackle or something, because, you know, Tackle's a pretty weak move. Because Tackle's base 35 with 95 accuracy, but Headbutt is twice as strong with full accuracy. So, I mean, it's really a perfect fit for Slowpoke. Because it's actually the move that Slowpoke used to start off with in Red and Blue. But they really only gave him that move to start with because, A, it took him a while to learn new moves, and B, you weren't able to catch it early on in the game. So it kind of balanced out a bit. Anyway, so it's good that we taught that to Martha Stewart there. She'll definitely appreciate it. It'll definitely show in battle. And look at this. Who's that? Kimono girl, lost and all alone. Poor girl lost in the dark, Ilex Forest. What? You remember me from Violet City? You must be imagining. Anyway, will you show me how to get out of this forest? Well, you know, you're kind of just sta- Okay. You- No, I'm not. It's like a linear path. How are you lost in here? Agent Spooner's like, alright, look, bitch, this is where you go. Come on, you freaking stupid or something. Just come on over here. You're such a smart Pokemon! Dead! Dun dun dun! Aw, yeah. Agent Spooner at it again. Agent Spooner's just like, well, man, she wasn't cuddly at all. Aw, man. Found an ether? Hell yeah. Alright, so I may as well, I'll use these, like, kind of lone trees here to demo what, Headbutt's all about. If you walk up to any tree that looks like this, and you have a Pokemon with Headbutt, it'll work just like a field move or a TM. You can smack the tree with it, and if you're lucky, you'll find a wild Pokemon in the tree. Oh, jeez, and talk about lucky! Good lord! We found a Pineco! So this is pretty cool. Pineco, they're, for some reason, they're bug types. I don't know why. Like, they say that they're bagworms, but I wasn't gonna catch it anyway, but anyway. They're supposedly the bagworm Pokemon. But, like, they're freaking pine cones. Like, come on, like, make them grass type. Like, frig. So stupid. But anyway. Is there, like, a secret item or something here? There isn't. I guess just another tree that we're apparently gonna interact with. I thought there's, like, a hidden item there, but... Oh, maybe that's where one of the weekday children are, maybe. I don't remember. I don't think so. In the Crystal remakes, there used to be a bug catcher right there, I'm pretty sure. Hey, girl! Try using this TM. Perfect. I'm not gonna use it, but hey, thanks. So yeah, again, in the original game, she also used to give you TM-12. But in Generation 2, TM-12 actually wasn't the TM for Taunt. It was Sweet Scent, which is why she has the Butterfree beside her. Which was cool because if people had Pokemon beside them and they gave you a TM, the Pokemon that they had with them was always an example of a Pokemon that could learn the TM. So it kind of gave you an idea of like, okay, like it's these kind of Pokemon that can learn it. It was excellent learning strategy, you know, just having to just use your observational skills to, not even to learn, but to make assumptions, and through that assumption, you know, experiment, and then come up with a result. It's a science experiment, man. It's science, dude. Pokemon is science, man. It's friggin' smart, alright? It's a friggin' intelligent game. I've gotta tell you, it's brilliant. Anyway, we're fighting a youngster who has a Rattata. What else is new, am I right? Like, the frig, man. Poor guy. Like, how do they get all these taglines? People, like, make fun of them in school and stuff. Like, youngster, 7 years old. And he's like, I'll show you, 7 years old. I'm gonna go and catch a Rattata for myself. And then they all just, like, go around and, like, catch these friggin' rats out in the wild. Like, not even, like, catch them in Pokeballs either. Like, kind of, like, throw their baseball caps on top of them and, like, scoop them up. And they're, like, really vicious. They're like... And they're just like, you're my new best friend. Meanwhile, Rattata's like gnawing his ear off. Mike Tyson Rattata. Good lord. I'm sorry. I've just been making a mockery of this guy the whole time. I am so not sorry. I'm actually not sorry at all, but hey, I'm trying to sound sympathetic. Meanwhile, Martha Stewart's just ramming through everyone here. As you can see, that headbutt is freaking awesome. Unfortunately, not even one tackle would probably KO a level 8 Spearow in one hit. But, man, headbutt does the trick, dude. We'll continue along the golden brick road here, the yellow brick road, sorry. That's how it's phrased in The Wizard of Oz. Now look at this guy. He's got the freaking kid on his back, who should probably be like over at the daycare, which is just north of us. And he's just walking around with them like an irresponsible white person. I just don't understand, man. I don't get it. I think that's why Unova tried to like diversify it so much. You think? Like, maybe the creator of Pokemon is a huge fan of the Boondocks? Or like a newfound fan? And he watched the Christmas episode and he was just like, wow. Or sorry. Wow, there are lots of irresponsible white people in the Pokemon world. And then he just like, he's like, alright, for the next game, less irresponsible white man. And then they're like, okay, let's create an Iris. Let's create, I already forget the other one's name. I already forget it, man. Good lord. The like the second gym leader in the first black and white, I guess. It's bothering me now that I don't remember her name. Good lord. Well, in the future, friggin' put that name down in the friggin' meta space down there. Please do that for me. Because I'm too busy, man. I'm a busy man. I'm killing Mareeps. And there's nothing you can do about it. I'm also at a very huge disadvantage right now. Good lord. Man! Martha Stewart, come on! You can't be paralyzed, alright? You gotta be up on stage in like 5 minutes. This is not ending well. One more... Dude. Oh my god. Martha Stewart, how did you do that? You're lucky that that trainer is very stupid with its Mareep. Pokefan, come on, man. If you're such a fan of Pokemon, you should friggin' know how they work. Thundershock. That's all you needed. Anyway. I guess I shouldn't complain. I'm awake, dude. Oh yeah, I took down a Rattata in the wild the other day. It was a cakewalk. Well, I guess it can't be helped. Us being so tough. Alright, later. Friggin' stupid ass Joey. Still trying to train off of like level 2 Rattata in the grass back there. Good lord. Okay. Let's see. Man, Martha Stewart is not loving that right now. Not digging that. I don't think I have... Oh, I do, though. Look at that. I do have Paralyze Heal. And whatever. I'll try throwing a potion on you or something. There we go. I just want to see if he can at least take down this last youngster over here. Because my goal for this episode was to make it to after the daycare, pretty much just the daycare cutscene, and that will perfectly fit into place as long as, you know, Martha Stewart doesn't screw things up like she always does. Am I right? Your recipes aren't that good. I'm sorry. Just take out that Mankey for me. Mankey was always a Pokemon I thought should have been normal type and not fighting type. I mean, I don't know. I really thought it should have been like normal. Or like, I don't know, maybe it could have been the first like normal fighting? I don't know, that's just me, but anyway. I guess Martha Stewart doesn't really care. Good lord. Oh my god. Are you serious right now? There we go. Oh man, I thought he was about to completely screw me with the flinching. I would not have been a happy panda. I would have been the complete opposite of Martha Stewart. Martha Stewart isn't a panda. Oh my god, no man. I don't want your number actually. Nah man, I'm not adding you on Facebook. I can't stand cocky son of a guns like you. Well, we're gonna walk up here. Grandpa! And look at that, oh, plot twist! Lyra's grandparents are the daycare couple. Good work, Grandpa. The Pokemon you raised for me has been as healthy as can be. You look fit, too. Hi, Will! Oh, dude, look, I'm being called over. Look, now we both have water types. Look, except mine's way cooler, though. Just throwing that out there, I've got to say. Slowpoke is way cooler than Meryl. Let me introduce you. This is Will! He's a trainer. He seems to be getting better at raising Pokemon. Well, not as good as you, Grandpa, of course. So, about that free raising of the Pokemon. Right. Okay. Follow me, Will! Alright, man. You gonna strike me up a deal in he? Strike me up a deal? Aw, man, I love the little playpen off to the right that they have in this game. I love it, man. It's so cool. Grandma! Let me introduce my friend. This is Will! Aha! This is your boy! Friend! Oh my god, man. Alright, now let the tsundere-ness begin. I see. What? Grandma, what are you talking about? He just happens to live nearby. He's not like gonna like you or anything. Ha ha ha. I know. Oh, you cocky son of a gun, you. Oh my god. Smug mother of a daughter. Since you brought him here, Lyra, you must be sure about his talent. Right, Will? Come and see us anytime. Well, I better go now. See ya! Oh, I almost forgot. Oh, dude, you just like shoved your Meryl out of the way. That's not nice. This is my Pokégear number. Will! Registered Lyra in the Pokégear. You know, I think this has to be like that old Pokemon Flash cartoon. The Pokemon P-Red from Newgrounds. Love it. Oh, look at this. Don't you say anything. We are both trainers, and we are supposed to exchange numbers. That's all.
It's not like I like him or anything.
Oh man, yeah, but like I was just about to say, I timed it poorly right there. But in this Pokemon P Red Flash movie, I'm gonna post that down in the friggin' description now too. Look at that. It's actually really not funny now. It has like really bad. It's just like meme humor pretty much. But there's always the one part that gets me where every time it's trying to like redo, like it's like recreating the Kanto games pretty much, but like putting humor in it. And every time you meet up with your rival, like you meet up with like Blue or Gary or whoever you want to call him, every time he walks off, it plays like a tiny little clip of the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air theme song. So I feel like every time that the rival or even just like Lyra walks off, it should just go like, I pulled up to the house about 7 or... It should totally have that, man. I think just every Pokemon game should have that. They should buy, like, licensing rights to it and everything, but... You know, I keep trying to email Nintendo about it, but they never get back to me, so... I don't know. I guess they don't want Fresh Prince. You know, they don't want the Fresh Prince of Kanto. The Fresh Prince of Johto. Fresh Prince of Unova. Good lord. That would be great. Oh, look at this. Oh, gosh. I have an idea. I'll give you our numbers. Alright. Cool. Awesome. Let's end the episode off on that because, you know, getting phone numbers from old people is pretty intense. So, I hope you all have a very good life. Or afterlife, if you're definitely not the old friggin' daycare couple, because they're in every friggin' game ever. And they're supposed to be old, but man, look at them. They're still... They are ripe with energy, dude. Look at them. Good lord. They are some spry young saplings, let me tell ya. We're gonna gaze out on the ocean together. It's gonna be a very romantic time, isn't it, Martha? Peace. Oh, so beautiful.